Goose is one of several different, you know, front end software interfaces that you can engage different LLMs, right? Mm-hmm. And it's open source. And what was just recently announced as well is Block, who created Goose, has now created a new group that's very much like Spiral, the group I run, and that it's independent of commercial interest by Block. And they, I think they're starting off with 5 developers focused on Goose open source software development. So just a further commitment to open source Goose and have this independent group of engineers. And a grant program was announced similar to what Spiral has done for 6 years now. So I think that's super exciting. And, you know, I think there's interest by Goose to like right now, Goose, I think, is optimized for like automating workflows, and whether you're at a corporation or if you're programming, like a lot of the vibe coding Jack has done has been done through Goose.
And just to clarify, in case people are unaware of Goose, you may be aware of like a Cursor or a Windsurf. Those are sort of closed source commercial IDE like things, you know, VS Code forks and stuff, or VS Code itself with plugins. But Goose is sort of, you know, in the same vein as that kind of thing, but a lot more just the chat and not really trying to kind of also present the code. So think of it as like an open source, very chat focused kind of competitor to the closed source Cursors and Windsurfs of the world, just to kind of set some context.
Yeah. And in general, I think, I mean, my own experience and talking like with you and a few other people, is that it's not as good of out of box experience relative to some of the commercial ones. But it is quite powerful. Like if you put in the effort, you can create really great stuff. So I think, you know, the optimist view there is just, it's just a matter of time. Like,
it'll probably level up.
Exactly.
And the hope is it's open source. So it'll get, and certainly Block's hope is that it's not just a Block thing. It's a public good.
Yeah.
Lots of other contributors. And so I am excited to see this new initiative that's Spiral-like independent group starting off with like 5 experienced engineers, but having this grant program as well.
So cool.
Do they have a Steve Lee equivalent? Do we know who it is?
There is a lead.
Okay, it's not announced yet.
I don't know if it's announced yet.
Okay.
But it's not a Steve Lee.
But
there is a lead.
interestingly, he worked at Google way back when we worked at Google.
Oh,
so
wow.
early Google guy.
Google's having a comeback. All right. I see your Twitter on that too.
Yeah. So I'm in touch with him and I'm like, hey, you know, I'm happy to give advice when, you know, anytime I can help out, since I've been doing this for 6 years now at the company. So I think that's really exciting. And then one thing I talked to him about which we talked about.
Work here.
Yeah. Is like, you know, Presidio Bitcoin. Yes, it has Bitcoin in the title and it's Bitcoin, but as people know, first of all, on this show, we talk about AI a lot. We talk about the intersection of AI and Bitcoin.
And we talk about open source all the fucking time.
Open source.
Yeah.
And so, the hackathon we hosted here in May, AI was a big part of it in multiple ways, using AI tools, vibe code, like half the participants vibe coded their apps, and half of the top 4 were vibe coded apps. And then also, we talk a lot about AI, like agents using Bitcoin as payments. So there's so much intersection between those two topics. I think it's a natural home for people who want to work on open source AI, open source Goose, that they'd be welcome members here and like really have a rich environment to do their work, be around other open source advocates.
So cool.
Remember when I brought Adrian by here, he specifically wanted to come by to see what this felt like, because he was like, I kind of want to do an open source, you know, kind of an AI focused open source kind of workspace. It's not about startups, but it's more about helping support those kinds of contributors. So maybe this actually becomes
that
the kind of place that he was envisioning.
And especially, I mean, I hear through the grapevine there are more and more parts of the building opening up. So maybe the next move we just expand.
Is that right?
Yeah. Well,
the yoga studio.
I don't know. The yoga studio is safe. Don't worry.
Okay.
So the 5 full time engineers on that team, I already checked. They don't live in the Bay Area, so I don't think they're going to work here.
Not yet.
But yeah, not yet. Well, the lead I've definitely invited. I think he's going to come visit this fall.
Okay.
So then he'll see firsthand how great Presidio Bitcoin is. But for people listening, or if you know folks that would be interested in a grant to work on open source Goose,
so cool.
First of all, awesome. And then if you happen to be in the Bay Area or want to live in the Bay Area and you want to be, you know, at a great space to work from with other awesome people, check out Presidio Bitcoin.
Can people just hop on like the GitHub, and are there a set of lists or roadmap ideas of kind of what features or what big projects or topics Goose is about to undertake?
I believe so. I think they just published like a, you know, like here's the top five priorities. And just to summarize some product roadmap ideas for Goose, well, we've talked about like prompt engineering and prompt skill development and prompt sharing and prompt education, all those things, like, and creating a library. Is that on Nostr, GitHub, whatever? You know, maybe not. Maybe it's the data stored on Nostr and it's integrated into Goose. Like it's just part of Goose. That's one thing that could be facilitated. We just talked about live streaming. You know, maybe that's like a separate project, but integrated into Goose in a seamless way. And awareness is created through Goose.
Yeah.
So I think there's a lot. And then one thing I've talked to them a little bit about is privacy. Like I love what Maple AI is doing and Open Secret. Now with Goose, it's client side and you can run a model on your computer too. So I mean, one way to get privacy is just run a model on your computer, run Goose on your computer, and then it's all local. But if you want to use a beefier or either, you know, if you don't want to set that up, if it's too much friction, or two, if you want to run a open source model that is too beefy to run on your computer, not beefy enough, then
not enough pull-ups.
I think you need enough pull-ups. Then, two of the Ultra 3s.
Then, you know, what's the privacy story there?
Yeah.
And it depends on the application. Like you're saying you want all your prompts to be literally public, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So obviously for those use cases, privacy doesn't really, I mean, it's like literally the opposite of privacy.
Right.
But certainly for corporate stuff, for health, like if any individual who's wanted to ask health questions, things like that, is going to be very privacy sensitive.
Yep.